November 17th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, Ezekiel chapters 47 and 48 from the Old Testament. Then he brought me back to the entrance of the temple. I noticed that water was flowing from under the threshold of the temple towards the east, for the temple faced east. The water was flowing down from under the right side of the temple, from south of the altar. He led me out by way of the north gate, and brought me around the outside of the outer gate that faces toward the east. I noticed that the water was trickling out from the south side. When the man went out toward the east with a measuring line in his hand, he measured 1,750 feet. And then he led me through the water, which was ankle deep. Again, he measured 1,750 feet and led me through the water, which was now knee deep. Once more, he measured 1,750 feet and led me through the water, which was waist deep. Again, he measured 1,750 feet, and it was a river I could not cross, for the water had risen. It was deep enough to swim in, a river that could not be crossed. He said to me, "Son of man, have you seen this?" Then he led me back to the bank of the river. When I had returned, I noticed a vast number of trees on the banks of the river, on both sides. He said to me, "These waters go out toward the eastern region and flow down into the Arabah. When they enter the Dead Sea, where the sea is stagnant, the waters become fresh. Every living creature which swarms where the river flows will live. There will be many fish, for these waters flow there. It will become fresh, and everything will live where the river flows. Fishermen will stand beside it, from En Gedi to En Eglaim. They will spread nets. They will catch many kinds of fish, like the fish of the great sea. But its swamps and its marshes will not become fresh. They will remain salty. On both sides of the river's banks, every kind of tree will grow for food. Their leaves will not wither, nor will their fruit fail, but they will bear fruit every month. Because their water source flows from the sanctuary, their fruit will be for food, and their leaves for healing." This is what the Sovereign Lord says. "Here are the borders you will observe as you allot the land to the 12 tribes of Israel. Joseph will have two portions. You must divide it equally, just as I vowed to give it to your forefathers. This land will be assigned as your inheritance. This will be the border of the land. On the north side, from the great sea, by way of Hethlon to the entrance of Zedad, Hamath, Berotha, Sibraim, which is between the border of Damascus and the border of Hamath, as far as Hazer Hatakan, which is on the border of Haran. The border will run from the sea to Hazer Enon, at the border of Damascus, and on the north is the border of Hamath. This is the north side. On the east side, between Haran and Damascus, and between Gilead and the land of Israel, will be the Jordan. You will measure from the border to the eastern sea. This is the east side. On the south side, it will run from Tamar to the waters of Meribath Kadesh, the river to the great sea. This is the south side. On the west side, the great sea will be the boundary to a point opposite Lebo Hamath. This is the west side. This is how you will divide this land for yourselves among the tribes of Israel. You must allot it as an inheritance among yourself and for the foreigners who reside among you, who you have fathered sons among you. You must treat them as native-born among the people of Israel. They will be allotted an inheritance with you among the tribes of Israel. In whatever tribe the foreigner resides, there you will give him his inheritance, declares the Sovereign Lord. These are the names of the tribes from the northern end beside the road of Hethlon to Lebo Hamath as far as Hazer Enon, which is on the border of Damascus toward the north besides Hamath, extending from the east side to the west. Dan will have one portion. Next to the border of Dan from the east side to the west, Asher will have one portion. Next to the border of Asher from the east side to the west, Naphtali will have one portion. Next to the border of Naphtali, from the east side to the west, Manasseh will have one portion. next to the border of Manasseh, from the east side to the west, Ephraim will have one portion. Next to the border of Ephraim, from the east side to the west, Reuben will have one portion. Next to the border of Reuben, from the east side to the west, Judah will have one portion. Next to the border of Judah, from the east side to the west, will be the allotment you must set apart. It is to be 8.25 miles wide, and the same length as one of the tribal portions, from the east side to the west. The sanctuary will be in the middle of it. The allotment you set apart to the Lord will be 8.25 miles in length, and 3 1/3 miles in width. These will be the allotments for the holy portion. For the priests toward the north, 8.25 miles in length. Toward the west, 3 1/3 miles in width. Toward the east, 3 1/3 miles in width. And toward the south, 8.25 miles in length. The sanctuary of the Lord will be in the middle. This will be for the priests who are set apart from the descendants of Zadok, who kept my charge and did not go astray when the people of Israel strayed off, like the Levites did. It will be their portion from the allotment of the land, a most holy place next to the border of the Levites. Alongside the border of the priest, the Levites will have an allotment 8.25 miles in length and 3 1/3 miles in width. The whole length will be 8.25 miles, and the width 3 1/3 miles. They must not sell or exchange any of it. They must not transfer this choice portion of land, for it is set apart to the Lord. The remainder 1 2/3 miles in width and 8.25 miles in length will be for common use by the city for houses and for open space. The city will be in the middle of it. These will be its measurements. The north side will be 1.5 miles. The south side, 1.5 miles. The east side, 1.5 miles. And the west side, 1.5 miles. The city will have open spaces. On the north, there will be 437.5 feet. On the south, 437.5 feet. On the east, 437.5 feet, and on the west, 437.5 feet. The remainder of the length alongside the holy allotment will be 3 1/3 miles to the east and 3 1/3 miles toward the west, and it will be beside the holy allotment. Its produce will be for food for the workers of the city. The workers of the city from all the tribes of Israel will cultivate it. The whole allotment will be 8.25 miles square. You must set apart the holy allotment with the possession of the city. The rest on both sides of the holy allotment and the property of the city will belong to the prince. Extending from the 8.25 miles of the holy allotment to the east border and westward from the 8.25 miles to the west border, alongside the portions, it will belong to the prince. The holy allotment and the sanctuary of the temple will be in the middle of it. The property of the Levites and of the city will be in the middle of that which belongs to the prince. The portion between the border of Judah and the border of Benjamin will be for the prince. As for the rest of the tribes from the east side to the west side, Benjamin will have one portion. Next to the border of Benjamin from the east side to the west side, Simeon will have one portion. Next to the border of Simeon, from the east side to the west side, Issachar will have one portion. Next to the border of Issachar, from the east side to the west side, Zebulun will have one portion. Next to the border of Zebulun, from the east side to the west side, Gad will have one portion. Next to the border of Gad at the south side, the border will run from Tamar to the waters of Meribath Kadesh, to the stream of Egypt, and on to the great sea. This is the land which you will allot to the tribes of Israel, and these are their portions, declares the sovereign Lord. These are the exits of the city on the north side, 1.5 miles by measure. The gates of the city will be named for the tribes of Israel. There will be three gates to the north, one gate for Reuben, one gate for Judah, and one gate for Levi. On the east side, 1.5 miles in length, there will be three gates, one gate for Joseph, one gate for Benjamin, and one gate for Dan. On the south side, 1.5 miles by measure, there will be three gates, one gate for Simeon, one gate for Issachar, and one gate for Zebulun. On the west side, 1.5 miles in length, there will be three gates, one gate for Gad, one gate for Asher, and one gate for Naphtali. The circumference of the city will be 6 miles. The name of the city, from that day forward, will be The Lord Is There. God, my favorite part of these last couple chapters of Ezekiel, of course, is that beautiful vision of the water flowing out from the temple, from the altar, and giving life and bearing fruit and providing healing. And even though that's a gorgeous thing to talk about in this vision that you gave Ezekiel about the temple, we see this in our own lives. You give us life. And then if we continue to live our lives according to the plan that you have for us, we will bear fruit. And we will bear fruit by doing what we're supposed to do in this life that we have, by taking care of others, by showing them grace and mercy and patience and love. And not just loving easy people, but loving the really hard people as well. Bearing that amazing fruit, allowing people to see that we are your children and that we are glorifying you. I also know that there's healing properties in the life that you give us through your water. God, my heart has been shattered, I would say destroyed, by the world. There's some vicious things that can happen to people in this world. But I know a couple things. One, I know that you never stopped loving me no matter what happened to me. Two, I know you forgive the pieces of those situations that were mine. Three, I know you never left my side. And you wrapped your arms tight around me as I had to deal with those situations. And probably the most important part for me was the fact that you provided the healing. And it wasn't healing in the sense of this world where you heal a broken heart, but it was healing, almost closing up those past wounds that the world had created and giving me a completely new heart. One that could acknowledge those past pains, but use them in the future to help glorify you, God. I can't believe how many things in my past that were horrid things that happened to me, or things that I did that were horrid, that you are now using for good. You're actually causing fruit to come out of some of those bad choices. And not only that, but the healing has taken place. Because by getting to see the fruit from some of my past, it heals my heart and allows me to see how you want me to walk in this world. God, allow us to acknowledge where we are according to that living stream. Are we really, really far away from it? Are we wading our toes in the edge? Or are we just at that point where Ezekiel says, I can't go anymore because I'm going to have to start swimming? Where are we with that living water that you give us? God, thank you for providing the strength that we need to deal with this world. Thank you for empowering us with your grace and your mercy and your love so that we can glorify you by sharing that with others. And personally, I thank you so much for allowing healing to take place in my life so that I can stop being selfish and thinking about me and my pain, and I can go love your people, God. Even the hard to love ones, that by stopping all that energy going to my pain, then I have more opportunities to love people for you. God, I pray all this in the name of your Son, who definitely taught me about love. Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.